children. In the previous class, you were studying about history chapter and you have discussed about archaeological sources. Today, we'll be continuing the chapter with the study of literary sources. Now, what are literary sources? The sources which are in written form are called as literary sources. Common example of literary sources are manuscripts and inscriptions. But as we are talking about medieval period, the common example of literary sources for this period is manuscripts. So now the question comes, what are manuscripts? Manuscripts are the books written by hand long ago. When the people have written the books, those books are called as manuscripts. Initially, the people used to write on palm leaves and the bark of birch tree, which is found in Himalayas. But later on, during 13th century, paper was used for writing. And as the time moved on, paper was easily available. So when the paper was easily available, the number of texts or number of manuscripts went on increasing. So this was some literary sources. Now, moving ahead with the types of literary sources. So, first we'll be describing about religious literature. Anything which is in written form related to religious text or related to religions are termed as religious literature. Religious literature basically have commentaries or books written on the beliefs which is mentioned in Smritis, Puranas, etc. These gives us a complete information about various religious texts. Next literary source is secular literature. Secular means when anything is written related to a particular person or to a particular religion is called as secular literature. So, example of secular literature are chronicles. So, what is a chronicle? A chronicle means a record of the rule of the king and life at their court. Most of the chronicles were written during the Persian and Turkish eras. During this time, these literary sources or these books were written describing the life of the king. Some common example: Raj Tarangini by Kalhana. This was a literary source depicting about the kings of Kashmir. Second, Tariq-e-Firozshahi by Ziauddin Barni, which comprises the history of sultans of Delhi. Third is Khazain-ul-Futuh and Tughlaq-Nama by Amir Khusro. These are some of the chronicles during the medieval time. Next example of secular literature, autobiographies. So what is autobiography? Autobiography means when something is written related to our own life, or when a person writes about himself or herself, that is called as autobiography. Some common examples of autobiographies are Futuhat-e-Firozshahi by Firoz Shah, Tuzuk-e-Babur by Babur, Tuzuk-e-Jahangir by Jahangir. So these are basically examples of secular literature. Now moving to the next type of literary source, that is biography. Biography is something written on the life of other people. It means when you are inspired by somebody and you write a book related to its life, that is called as a biography. During the earlier times, mostly the kings used to have poets and writers in their court, and they used to write biographies about the rule of the king, which describes the life of the king, how they ruled, the life of common people, what are their policies. It consists of everything related to that particular king. So, some common examples of biographies in medieval period are Prithviraj Raso by Chand Bardai, Humayun Nama by Gulbadan Begum, Ayn-e Akbari and Akbarnama by Abul Fazl. These are some of the biographies of medieval period. Moving next to the next source are travelogues. Travelogues are the accounts which are written by the travelers. Many travelers of earlier times like Ibn Battuta, Marco Polo, Niccolo Ralphich, Bernier and Tavernier, they have described about the social and political conditions of the country during that time period. Next literary source is documents. Medieval documents comprises of records of land grants and land revenue, writings on history and science. And one of the main document of medieval period are firmans. Firmans are basically the orders or correspondences of the king. Whatever the king wants their subjects to know, those orders are known as firmans. During the medieval period, the manuscripts which are written are being taken by king, rich people, monasteries and temples. And these manuscripts are mostly kept in archives and libraries. Archive is basically a place where manuscripts are stored. So when kings used to take the manuscripts, they used to keep this in archives and they are being preserved there. Now also every state is having their own archives and libraries where these manuscripts are kept. But when we are talking about manuscripts, they are being written a long ago. So now historians are facing some problems in using these manuscripts and to know about history. Some reasons why historians are facing problem are, first, that the people used to write the manuscript again and again. It means once the manuscript is written by one person, the scribes used to write it again with changes in some words or in some points. But as these manuscripts are written again and again, it becomes very different from the original manuscripts. So we are not able to find out or to know that exactly what happened during that time. Second reason, authors even revise their chronicles again and again. So for example, Ziauddin Barni has written his chronicle in 1356 AD. He wrote its another version after 2 years. But when the new version came up, both these versions were different from each other. And even till 1916, the historians were not able to find out that what was written in the original version. Next feature why historians face problem in using manuscripts are, when the historians used to read about maps or text, they have to keep in mind that the time period during which these manuscripts were written, or they need to know the actual information about that time period before reading these texts or maps. Second, the last reason, they have to be careful about the terms used in the manuscripts and their meaning, because as we know, every word is having different meanings. So they have to keep in mind that what is the meaning of that particular word now and in that time period. So these are some problems which are faced by historians. Now we are going to study about new social and political groups. New social and political groups were formed in the society due to some reasons. So we are going to study the factors which led to the formation of new social and political groups. First factor is mobility. Mobility means movement of people from one place to another. In medieval times, generally the people travel from one place to another in search of wealth and opportunities. So in the same context, many people, they came to our country because of its immense wealth. So when they came to our country, they started using the resources of our country. And during this time, one of the political group which came up was of Rajputs, and this was the term generally used for the warrior class who claimed for Kshatriya's caste status. Next reason for the formation of social and political group was new ideas. When the travelers, they came to our country, they brought new concepts, new methods for agriculture, new crops and new ideas. And when these travelers brought all these things, it brought a great change in the social, political and economic life of the people, or it brought a drastic change in the society. Next factor is improvement in technology. During this time, technology also improved. In medieval period only, spinning wheel was introduced and firearms were introduced and Persian wheel was used in irrigation. So these are some of the technological changes which advanced the people. Next factor is new crops. As the travelers came in, they brought new types of crops with them, like tea, coffee, chili, corn, potatoes. These are some of the new crops introduced in the subcontinent during the medieval period. Next, we are going to study about new peasants group. In this, as we all know, because of the purpose of agricultural settlement, we need to clear the forest. So in this manner, in the medieval period also, for agriculture purpose, forests were being cleared and the people living in forest were being sent out of their habitat. So when they are being sent out, the people were forced to migrate from one place to another. And when they migrated, this resulted in the formation of new peasants group. And mostly the peasants group which were formed are being influenced by priests, regional markets, monasteries and temples. And they were being even asked to pay tribute to the local lords and offer their services to them. So in this manner, new peasants group are formed, and in that too, some of the peasants group were having lands, and some of the peasants, they were being given small tasks under the landlords and they have to do their work under them, or they have to work in their fields. So in this way, two different type of peasants group are formed. Some, those who are owning the land and the landlords, and the other groups which were forced to do the small task and to give their service to the landlords. Now we are going to study about jatis. So what are jatis? Jatis are the subcaste. When the society got differentiated, then jatis are formed. People were divided as per the jatis. And the criteria for dividing these jatis were the background and the occupation of the people. So when we discuss about jatis, even the jatis were ranked. And the rank of the jatis depend on the power and the resources which the members of the jati are having. And even the status of the jatis keep on changing as per the conditions of the members of a jati. Now, when we discuss about jatis, all the works of the jatis are maintained in a systematic manner and having particular type of rules and regulations. So the affairs of jatis are maintained in following ways. First way is that every jati is having its own rules and regulations to maintain the working of the members. It means the members of a jati has to follow the rules and regulations of the jati for doing their work. Second point, every member of the jati has to follow the rules of the village also. It means other than their own rules and regulations, the village where these people are living, the members of the jati have to follow the rules and regulations of the village too. Third point, an assembly of elders, that is jati panchayat, is formed, which bring these rules and regulations into practice. Just take an example, as in our constitution, an executive is responsible to enforce all the rules and regulations formed by the legislature. In the same manner, Jati Panchayat is responsible to enforce the rules and regulations formed by the Jati members. Next factor, every village is being governed by a chieftain. Chieftain means a person who is the head. As when we talk about our villages, there is a sarpanch. In the same manner, every jati is also ruled by the head member who is known as chieftain. Now next, moving ahead with the political developments during the medieval period. So first political development is important groups of people emerged. Earlier we have studied that Rajputs came up as an important warrior class. So when we discuss about important groups of people, Rajputs were the first group who emerged as a warrior class, and basically the meaning of Rajput is the son of a ruler. But still it included the rulers, soldiers and commanders of different monarchs in the subcontinent. Rajputs were very courageous. As per their name too and as per their works done, they were termed as very courageous and were very loyal. So other groups which came up were of Marathas, Sikhs, Ahoms and Kayas. They even equally became politically important during the medieval period. Next political development is of region and empires. As we have discussed that medieval period is a stage of development and the spread of empires. So during that time, the kingdoms of north and south, they were in continuous conflicts with each other. And most prominent among these kingdoms were of Rajputs in north and Chola kingdom in south. These kingdoms were continuously in revolt with each other. It led to a rise and fall in the kingdoms. So in the later medieval period, even we can see the rise of powerful Muslim dynasties like Khiljis, Tughlaqs and Mughals. According to a Sanskrit Prashasti. Now what is a Prashasti? Prashasti means when something is written in praise of the king, that is called as a Prashasti. So according to a Sanskrit Prashasti, the ruler of Delhi, Sultan Ghiyasuddin, his kingdom spread from Bengal in east to Afghanistan in west. Other than this, some of the dynasties were also able to build an empire during the medieval period, and those dynasties were of Cholas, Khiljis, Tughlaqs and Mughals. They were even equally important dynasties which set up their empire in medieval period. When we discuss about 18th century, the time when Mughal Empire declined, during that time, after the decline of Mughal Empire, many small regions came up. Because as an empire declined, so again the small kingdoms, they declared themselves as independent. So in this manner, many smaller kingdoms re-emerged in our subcontinent. There was one factor which affected it, that kingdoms emerged but they were being somehow affected by the dynasties which were before them, or the characters of those dynasties were still influencing the new kingdoms and it has brought a change. So according to this, the result was that the governance and management of economy, culture and language was having the traditions of the previous dynasties. So in this manner, all these dynasties were being affected by the traditions, by the culture and by the characteristics of the previous dynasty. So now we are going to sum up whatever we have studied. So summary of today's class is, literary sources are the books written by hand and are called manuscripts. Literary sources are religious literature, secular literature, biographies, travelogues and documents. Example of secular literature are chronicles and autobiographies. Earlier manuscripts were different from the later ones. New social and political groups were formed because of mobility of people, emergence of new ideas, and development in technology. New peasants groups and jatis emerged. Important groups of people during medieval period were Rajputs, Marathas, Sikhs, Jat, Ahoms and Kayas. The later medieval period saw the rise of Muslim dynasties such as Khiljis, Tughlaqs and Mughals. So this was all for today's class, and in the next class we are going to continue with the chapter and we'll be discussing about old and new religions which were prevalent in the society during the middle period. So goodbye for now. Stay home, stay safe.